I'll leave the fireworks to the pros. As long as I've got food, I am good. And when it comes to food, of course, Chef Nanny Bubby, she's got some great recipes. She's sharing another one with us today.
But we're starting, of course, to encourage all of you to send in recipes for a happy marriage for Courtney and Chris.
This is so nice of you to do this for me.
Marla at chefnannybubby.com. Get your recipes in. They're all coming in. It's going to be so fun.
Oh, my goodness.
So we're going to start today just with a tip that I ran out of time to give last time. And that is that everything that I make, fruits, vegetables, I spray with food-grade hydrogen peroxide.
Food-grade hydrogen peroxide?
Yes.
There was such a thing.
There is, and you can find it on Amazon. Comes in a gallon. You put it 3 to 1, 3 water, 1 hydrogen peroxide. Everything we cook, we spray with the hydrogen peroxide. We soak it in water, and then...
Because it always seems so messy to clean them, and I'm just like, eh, forget it. It's probably not that bad.
But let me tell you, it brings out the flavor in everything you do, too, because so many things are touched by so many hands by the time they get to you. There's coating sometimes put on it. This gets rid of
vinegar,
everything.
I feel like the taste kind of soaks up in it.
Yes, and it brings
it
out.
So this is what we're cooking over there. So I think, Jenny, if you can get a shot of that, or she's going to move it. So
there
let's hold it up, girl.
Yeah,
there we go.
There we go.
That is a berry trifle.
I'm leaning.
I thought it was a typo. What's a trifle?
This is a trifle.
A trifle. I was like, trifle.
There's a truffle and there's a trifle.
So how do we make a trifle?
So we started first with angel food cake. Now, you can use vanilla wafers, you can use pound cake, but for 4th of July, I like angel food cake because it's white.
I'll just eat
but you have to cut the crust off, as you can see. That way, only the white is showing.
Okay.
We started here, we spread it with raspberry jam, put a little sprinkle of raspberry frambois, a liqueur on it.
Okay.
And you see these holes?
Okay.
So go ahead and break these apart and just just break them apart and stuff them
stuff
in the holes.
In the hole?
Yep. There you go. Just so that the white is there.
Okay.
There you go.
I
a little bit more.
Alrighty.
Okay.
So I love that you always give me the stuff that you would give your little granddaughter.
Yeah, yeah. I love you because you're like a daughter to me, my darling. Now we're gonna start. Go ahead and layer up. Yep. Go ahead.
Oh, you just told me to wash my hands, and now I'm gonna do this.
Yep. But that's it.
All right, so can I just do this?
Yes, just do it.
So does it matter what way I layer it?
Well, just you want the blue towards the end because it's going to layer up as red, white, and blue.
Okay.
So go ahead and get the blue, spread them out so they hit the end.
All right, the edge there.
Now we have our fabulous whipped cream, which is fabulous because we love whipped cream when it whips perfectly, which this did.
Okay.
So we're going to layer that around like this. Can you believe we have
And you literally just use whipping cream and put
cream
it and
cheese.
It.
It's cream,
cream cheese,
which has...
How do you get that smooth?
Right, it has to be room temperature. However, your whipped cream cannot be room temperature. It won't whip. Okay.
Okay.
So now you're going to put on another layer of the angel food cake. I'll help you because we only have a minute left.
Yes. Put it on down.
Yep.
This is so easy.
Yep. Now spread your strawberries.
Oh, don't break anything. All righty.
There we go. We're getting
there. On top.
Spread it on.
I'm going. I'm going.
Yeah.
All right.
And now we're going to finish up with whipped cream.
This looks so fancy.
Isn't that fabulous? Look how fast it is, too.
Oh, my goodness.
Once you have everything prepared and you use your hydrogen peroxide to clean, you get all your whipped cream on. Now start putting those raspberries around the outside.
Alrighty.
Blueberries, I'll help you on the inside.
Alrighty. This is so easy.
And then...
Now, can I just walk into the party with it like this, or do we have to, like, wait for it to set or anything?
Whoops, let me step out of the shot here, and let me just tell you, in the end, after you put the blueberries in the middle, you're going to put a... And there you go.
You're done.
There's your trifle. Happy 4th of July.
And you walk in with that, and this is a great centerpiece, too, I think.
Isn't it fabulous?
To greet the guests when they come in, and they know that, like, this ain't your average party. This is a Nanny Bubby party. Thank you for joining us again. Always so much fun. Always so yummy. You can get more recipes and tips. Just follow Chef Nanny Bubby on social media. And remember to email your recipes for my bridal book to Marla at chefnannybubby.com. Mercedes, over to you. This